Hello students, I welcome you all for understanding our first chapter of Social and Political Life 1, which is Understanding Diversity. Now, before we begin, let's first understand the meaning of our book's name, which is Social and Political Life. Now, we all know that man is a social animal, in a sense that we don't live alone. We all are social animals. We need family, we need friends, we love spending time with our parents, with our friends. We work together as a community. We all have a sense of brotherhood amongst ourselves. We all have a social life. Now, what is a political life? Now, if we are living in a group or a community, there might be conflicts because sab ek jaise nahi sochte. That is, not everyone is the same, right? So we have our different opinions, so there might be some conflicts also. So there must be a system where there is some form of power relations amongst ourselves. Matlab ki agar humne aapas mein ladai aur jhagda kar liya, to koi to hona chahiye jo is conflict ko solve kare. So take an example of your class. When a teacher goes out of the class, students start making noise. या फिर कोई दो स्टूडेंट आपस में किसी बात पे लड़ रहे होते हैं, तो फिर सब ठीक करने के लिए हमारा क्लास मॉनिटर आता है. टीचर ने उसको अथॉरिटी दी होती है कि सब उसकी बात मानेंगे. सिमिलरली, व्हेन वी लिव इन अ कम्युनिटी, हमें भी कोई डिसीजन मेकर चाहिए होता है जो हमें सही डायरेक्शन पे लेके जाए. सो पॉलिटिकल लाइफ इज़ बेसिकली अ सेट ऑफ एक्टिविटीज़ that are associated with making decisions in groups. Alright? Now, what are our learning objectives? Now, at the end of this lesson, you will be able to observe various kinds of diversity in our everyday environment. Hum samjhenge ki kitni forms hain diversity ki hamari aam zindagi mein. Second, we'll understand the difference between diversity and inequality. Thirdly, we'll explain the diversity in India and also how historical and geographical factors can influence diversity. And the last topic is that we'll explain the concept of unity in diversity in the context of India. Alright? So now, we all have sung our national anthem in our morning assemblies, but do we know its meaning? So let's understand what does our national anthem means. Alright? Now, the song Jana Gana Man is the national anthem of India, which was composed by Rabindranath Tagore. It was originally composed in Bengali language and it was adopted in its Hindi version by the Constituent Assembly as the National Anthem of India on January 24th, 1950. But pehli baar ise gaya gaya tha in the year 1911 at the Calcutta session of the Indian National Congress. Now, the full anthem consists of 5 stanzas, which takes about 52 seconds to play. Now, on certain occasions, a shorter version of the song consisting of the first and the last lines of the stanza is played, that takes around 20 seconds. Alright, so let's begin. Let's understand its meaning. So the first line says, Jana Gana Man Adhinayak Jaya Hai Bharat Bhagya Vidhata. So here, Jan means public, Gan means group, Man means mind, Adhinayak means our leader, Jayahe means victory, right? Bharat means India, our country. Bhagya means destiny, matlab kismat. Vidhata means creator, matlab rachne wala. To kehne ka matlab hua ki jan gan ke man mein base us adhinayak ki jay ho jo Bharat ke bhagya vidhata hai. एक्चुअली कहा गया है कि ये जो सॉन्ग है वो एक वेलकम सॉन्ग था जो इंग्लैंड के किंग जॉर्ज फिफ्थ के वेलकम में गाया गया था जब वो इंडिया में आए थे. भारत उस टाइम उनके अंडर गुलामी कर रहा था, तो कुछ लोग बोलते हैं कि नेशनल एंथम उनकी शान में लिखा गया था और बोला कि हमको ये नहीं गाना चाहिए, बट उस टाइम पर यही डिसाइड किया गया कि यही हमारा नेशनल एंथम होगा. तो फर्स्ट लाइन पे दोबारा आते हैं कि लोगों के मन में बसे उस लीडर की जय हो जो भारत के क्रिएटर हैं, राइट? नेक्स्ट पढ़ते हैं, पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंग विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जलधि तरंग। पंजाब मतलब पंजाब हो गया, सिंध मतलब हो गया इंडस, गुजरात इज गुजरात, मराठा इज महाराष्ट्र, द्राविड कहा गया है साउथ इंडिया को, द्राविड इज साउथ इंडिया, उत्कल इज उड़ीसा एंड बंग मीन्स बंगाल, विंध्य इज विंध्यास, हिमाचल इज हिमालयास, यमुना इज यमुना रिवर, गंगा इज गंगा रिवर, उच्छल मीन्स मूविंग, जलधि मीन्स ओशन एंड तरंग मीन्स वेव्स। तो कहते हैं कि विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना और गंगा से हिंद महासागर तक उत्साह की तरंगे उठती हैं। कहने का मतलब ये जितनी भी सारी जगहें हैं सब तुम्हारी जय जय बोलती हैं। तब शुभ नामे जागे तब शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तब जय गाथा। तब मीन्स योर, ठीक है, तुम्हारा। शुभ मीन्स ऑस्पिशियस मतलब मंगल, नामे मीन्स नेम, जागे मीन्स अवेकन, बोलते हैं ना जागो ग्राहक जागो, अवेकन टू अवेकन, आशीष मीन्स ब्लेसिंग्स और आशीर्वाद, मांगे मीन्स आस्क जब हम किसी से कुछ पूछते हैं, गाहे मीन्स सिंग गाना, तव मीन्स योर, जय मीन्स विक्ट्री, गाथा मतलब सॉन्ग। तो कहने का मतलब हुआ कि सब तेरे पवित्र नाम पर जाग उठते हैं, ठीक है, सब तुझसे पवित्र आशीष पाने की लालसा रखते हैं, सब तेरी ही जय गाथाओं का गान करते हैं। कहने का मतलब कि हम सब आपसे आशीर्वाद मांगते हैं, तुम्हारी शान में ये जय गाथा गाते हैं। नेक्स्ट बोलता है जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता, जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे। जन मतलब पब्लिक, गण मीन्स ग्रुप, मंगल मीन्स फॉर्च्यून या फिर भाग्य, दायक मीन्स गिवर, जय हो मीन्स विक्ट्री, भारत मीन्स इंडिया, भाग्य मतलब डेस्टिनी या फिर किस्मत, विधाता मतलब होता है क्रिएटर, जय हो मतलब हो गया विक्ट्री फॉर एवर। तो कहते हैं जन गण के मंगलदायक की जय हो, हे भारत के भाग्य विधाता, विजय हो विजय हो, तेरी सदा ही विजय हो। कहता है कि हे भारत के मंगल करने वाले तुम्हारी जय हो, भारत के लोग भारत की मिट्टी सब तुम्हारी जय जय बोलते हैं। सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड द मीनिंग ऑफ आर नेशनल एंथम। सो लेट्स प्रोसीड। Now let's understand what is diversity. Now suppose I ask each one of you your favorite sport, your favorite food, your most important festival, and which language do you speak at home. I'm sure I will get all different answers from all of you. For example, let's talk about Sam. All right, so Sam in your class says that I like football. Alright, I speak Malayalam at my home and my favorite food is biryani and my most important festival is Christmas. So there's another student named Rahul whose favorite game is again football and he speaks Hindi at his home, right? And his favorite food is Alu Parantha, alright? And his most important festival is Diwali. Now we have another student named Nisha. She likes swimming, she speaks Bengali at home and she likes fish curry and her most important festival is Durga Puja. There is another girl named Riya, alright. Now she loves to play tennis, she speaks Punjabi, alright. She likes Chinese food and her most important festival is Diwali. So what do you observe from the answers given by these students? Like you can see some share common interest. For example, both Rahul and Sam likes football, right? Both Rahul and Riya, their most important festival is Diwali, all right? But in other aspects, children are different from each other. As you can see, they speak different languages and like different types of foods. For example, some speak Malayalam as Sam and some speak Bengali like Nisha, right? But they all are friends, right? They study together in class, they play together. The same happens in your neighborhood. Now let's extend this thought to our country. So each individual is unique yet diverse. So to accept and respect differences between individuals while also understanding that each individual is unique outlines the concept of diversity. All right? So meaning we understand that we all are different from each other, but still we respect these differences and accept them as friends, right? Now let's proceed. Diversity and inequality. Let's take a situation that every day after school you buy ice cream from a boy named Rakesh. He is the same age of yours, but he never went to school like you do. And also he is very poor and does not have all the opportunities like you have. Now this is an example. Is this an example of diversity? No. All right, this is not the case of diversity, but it is the case of inequality. So here two students do not have the access to the same opportunities and resources, which shows inequality in our country. That is, some are rich while others are poor. People do not have access to same opportunities and resources in life. So this is what is called inequality. All right. Now, diversity in India. Now, India is a country of many diversities. Take for example, Punjab. Now, it is located in the northern part of India. Here, the land is very fertile and farming is the main occupation. Large population here follows Sikhism and native language is Punjabi. Lohri and Baisakhi are important festivals of this state. Now, let's move to West Bengal, a state in eastern India. Here, people speak Bengali and eat lots of fish. Here, Durga Puja is the main festival. Moving to south, let us look at the state of Kerala. Now, here, people speak Malayalam. Here, they use coconut as a key ingredient in their food. Onam is their main festival. So, what do you notice? We can clearly see that India is a very diverse land. There are many different languages, cultures, religions, and traditions followed throughout the India. All right? Now, how do we explain diversity? Now, can you think of some reasons of how India becomes such a diverse nation? Now, to understand this, let us assume that you're from Delhi. All right? You're from Delhi, and your father gets transferred to Chennai. Right? Now you start going to school there and your families had an interaction with the neighborhood. You will feel there are changes in a way you live and in a way they live. So you start adjusting to it, all right? So you start learning some words of Tamil and your mother starts preparing food, you know, she starts preparing some local dishes of Chennai based on some interactions with friends around. So your change of place had an impact on your culture. So people keep on moving from one state to another and you know they try to adjust to it, and when they try to adjust to it, they form their own cultures, they form their own traditions, right? So let's proceed. Now let's understand that what is the impact of geography and history on diversity. We'll take specific examples of, let's say, Ladakh and Kerala. Now, Ladakh became a union territory of India on 31st of October 2019, and Ladakh is renowned for its remote mountain beauty and distinct culture. And people here rear sheep, which gives a very special kind of wool called pashmina wool. All right, pashmina wool. Now the shawls made from this wool are called pashmina shawls, and they're very expensive and they're in demand across the world. Now Ladakh also has many passes which make travel possible from India to Tibet. Now traders use this route to carry spices, pashmina, raw silk and carpets, and Buddhism reached Tibet through Ladakh. And Islam was also introduced in this region 400 years ago, and now it has a significant Muslim population. Now, Kerala, let's look at Kerala. Kerala is a state in the southwest corner of India. It has sea on one side and mountains on the other side. And Kerala is famous for spices like cloves. Cloves is long. Cardamoms. Cardamoms is elaichi. Pepper, mirch, etc. So this made the region an attractive place for traders. Arabs and Jewish traders were the first to come. In fact, Christianity also came to India through Kerala 2000 years ago. And many Arab traders also settled here. So it has a Muslim population also. Now looking at these two examples, we can see that it was the geographical locations of these areas which led to people of various cultures visiting and settling in these places. So a diversity of a place is affected by its geography and also by its history. Alright. Now let's proceed and talk about unity in diversity. Now, India is a finest example of unity in diversity throughout the world. Now, when the British ruled India, they thought that they would divide Indians, you know, because they were so different from each other, and they continued their rule. But Indians, under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, Jawaharlal Nehru, stood united and fought against the British rule. And in fact, the term unity in diversity is coined by Jawaharlal Nehru to describe India in his book Discovery of India. The Discovery of India. Alright. I hope you understood the chapter. Thank you so much.